now. Did you ever think when the season started, because I know it was a lot of doubters, that you would be in this position?
Well, before we got on the floor, no, just because of our youth and what we were going to do. And I think when you get around practice and you see them develop, you see them grow, I understand where we are. We just made a commitment to work every day in practice. And I think now you're seeing the result of starting off a young team and now a more mature, experienced team.
Sunday, were you like, wow, thank you very much, LSU and Vandy?
I was. I congratulated Miss Caldwell, and it just kind of worked out. And it, you know, we got to take care of our end of the deal now. So as you couldn't write the script that well, we'll take it. We'll take all the help we can get.
What would a SEC title, a regular season title, mean for you in your first year?
It's exciting for these young ladies to go where they started and then where they ended up, and for this staff who, I tell you, has worked unbelievably hard and very dedicated to get this to where we are now. So as I think I understand as you go through, it's not about myself, it's about the collection of great staff and players we have. It's been an unbelievable year for me.
The growth and the maturation of the team, how much does having to fight through all these injuries, how much does that have to do with it?
Well, it's huge. It's huge when you have injuries that we had, and we had setbacks, and more people had to step up, and people had to play different positions. It was key. It was key to people putting aside what they thought they wanted to do and accept what we needed them to do. So I thought people stepped up and were huge in the time when we had some pretty key injuries.
Holly, do you feel like Isabel, did she come through Sunday okay? Do you feel like you can get her even some more?
You know, Dan, I do. I feel good about it. I wanted to play her more, but it just didn't work out. But I think Sunday and then yesterday's practice, she went extremely hard. And I think she'll no question be ready to go.
Holly, senior night is always emotional. Family's on the floor. You're saying goodbye to two players. But then you got to turn around and tip off not just a game, but the SEC title on the line. How does everybody get refocused on that task?
Well, I think they understand that both Tabor and Kamiko have done an unbelievable job this year in the leadership role. And I think our players will be excited for them. And I know their families will be here, and they'll be pumped up as well. But these two players, they enjoy the game. And so I think when all's said and done and we have the tip-off, I think everybody will be ready to play.
Talk about A&M. I mean, they bring Bone here. You guys recruited. She's having a great year.
Great year.
And they've retooled. I mean, they lost a lot of starters, but yet kind of similar to you guys in some ways, with the Bone exception.
You know, I think so. I think they have a strong presence inside, and they built their program this year around Kelsey Bone. And they're very athletic. They play hard. Defense is a priority for them. So it's a little bit of a mirror of both teams, of the philosophies, and he's a pretty strong defensive-minded coach as well. So I think you'll see an up-and-down game, very fast-paced game, physical. So it should be a really good contest.
What is it about Kelsey that makes her so difficult for opponents to handle?
I think she's big. She's gotten stronger. She's more mature. She has more arsenal, more weapons in her arsenal. I think she can do a lot more things than just catch and shoot. She can face. She can drive. So I think with a multidimensional player like Kelsey, it's difficult, especially with her presence inside of her being so physical.
What are your memories of these two seniors, Tabor and Kamiko?
Well, it's kind of strange. I just remember them coming in and being so young and not experienced, and to see Tabor maturity about her and getting the opportunity to play and guide, lead this team, and Kamiko coming in and maybe not her expectations early wasn't there for her. And I think the more she's been involved in this program and the more we've needed her, I think she understands the importance of being here and playing well for us as well. But both have done a phenomenal job of leading on and off the court, and that's what we ask them to do. That's what seniors are supposed to do. They're supposed to lead, and they've led by example. I'm very proud of them.
Coach, it's not a secret that they actually didn't like each other when they first came in here.
I didn't. Yeah.
So I mean, just to see them now, you know, get along, and you said the turning point was the injuries. Kind of, what did you see from them?
Well, you recruit kids, but they don't not all kids get along. There are different personalities, there's different makeups. But I think as they both matured and they both understood, they both were injured, and they understood their love for the game, I think it drew them closer. Now that they're the two lone seniors, I think that's given them a tremendous bond as well.
Is that nice to see?
Oh, absolutely. I don't want anybody to dislike somebody on the team. So I think it's been very healthy for those two. I think they've spent a lot of time trying to help the team overall, and getting ready as seniors to try to present to the underclassmen what needs to be done. And I think they've done an outstanding job.
Y'all haven't lost since that Missouri game. What did that teach y'all just about not having that much of a margin for error and knowing it wasn't a bit of a wake-up call?
Well, I think it was all about discipline and focus for us. We weren't very disciplined in that game. We were very lackadaisical. We let a team do what they wanted to do with their strength, three-point shooting. And we didn't come in prepared and ready to compete at that level. So I think it was a huge learning point, and I think it was great for our preparation. And since then, we have come in a game in practice and at pregames extremely prepared and pretty very, very focused.
Coach, for the girls that were on the team last year, and remember when LSU helped you guys out a little bit and you had a chance to have a share or even win the SEC title, then you guys lost to Arkansas. How much did that maybe help you this year, especially in that Arkansas game and then now?
Well, we talk about it. We had the SEC regular season in our hands, and we had two games on our home court, and we lost the two to Arkansas and South Carolina. So we talk about that. We address it. And as we have a chance to do it, it's not a given. We've got to go out and compete, just like Texas A&M is going to come in here and compete. They want to win as well. So it's about keeping our focus and understanding we've got to do the things that got us here. The same thing we got to do tomorrow night. So we can't look ahead. I can't sit there and think, wow, let's celebrate a championship when it hasn't happened. We got to take care of business.
Well, you know, you have a share, obviously, at least a chance for a share of a title. That's a given.
We don't want to share it. We want to win it outright, and that's been our goal all along. And so share is great. Please don't misinterpret that. I'm not appreciative, but we want the title to ourselves.
Awesome. Thanks, Coach.